Hello friends and welcome back. In this lecture, we're going to solve an exercise. So let's see what classes and methods we have in this exercise. Basically, we have two classes, a main class and a me class. So inside the main class, we have the main method. And in the me class, we have two methods, a say name method and a say age method. So this class over here will represent you, the programmer. The say name method will print your name and the say age method will print your age, okay? So this class over here will be used in the main class. Inside the main method, we want to call the say name method and the say age method using the name of the me class, okay? So as you can see, the me class doesn't have a main method. Only the main class will contain the main method. And we are going to use the me class inside this method over here, all right? And I want you to do this exercise with and without IntelliJ, okay? So what would be the output of the program? In my case, when we execute the main class, we're going to see my name and my age printed. And in your case, of course, you will print your name and your age, all right? So pause the video, try to make this exercise using IntelliJ and without using IntelliJ. And when you are done, come back to see my solution. So as you can see, I'm on my desktop. In order to organize the files, I'm going to create a new folder. And let's call this folder exercise, for example. You don't have to do this, but I'm just doing it to organize the files. Now inside this folder, I will create the two classes, okay? So I'm going to use Notepad, and let's create our main class. So it will be a public class, and it is called main. And then we open some braces. In here, we have the main method, right? So it is a public, static, void, main, and it takes some parameters, string, args, as you already know. Now inside the main method, we want to call the say name and the say age of the me class, right? So let's do that. We want to access the me class using the dot operator, and then we will call the say name method, like this. And after that, we will call the say age method in the same way. So me.sayAge, right? So let's think about this. First of all, because we are calling these methods inside another class, these methods have to be public. And because we are calling them using the name of the me class, they have to be static, right? Perfect. So now let's save our main class. So file, save as, and I will save it inside my exercise folder. And over here, we will call it main.java. It should be the same name as the class, all right? And over here, we will choose all files. Now let's press save. And as you can see, our file is saved. Now let's create our me class. So file, new file. So it is also a public class and it's called me. Inside the braces, we're going to make two methods, the say name method and the say age method. And we don't have a main method because as I said, we will execute the say name and the say age in the main class. We don't want a main method in this class. We don't want to do anything inside it, all right? So as we said, these methods should be public. And also, they should be static because we want to call them using the name of the class, right? Now let's think about the return type. Basically, these methods only print something. So they are void methods, right? So let's create the first one, which is say name, right? It takes no parameters and inside it, I just want to print my name. So let's access the system class and then the out object and then the println method. And in here, I will print my name like this, right? So this is it for the say name method. Now let's create the say age method. So over here, public, static, void, say age. So it is the same as the say name method. And in here, I'm going to print my age, all right? So system.out.println, and I will print my age. Now, if I print my age as a string or if I print it as a number, this will not make a difference. We will have the same output, all right? And let's add a semicolon. So now our me class is finished. So let's save it. File, save as. We want to save it as me.java. And we're going to choose all files. Now press the save button. And as you can see, our me class is ready. Now let me close this. And now we want to use CMD in order to compile and run our program. So let's open CMD. And first of all, I want to navigate to the desktop because this folder over here is in the desktop. So CD, desktop, like this. After that, I want to navigate inside this folder because the classes are inside this folder, right? So CD exercise like this. And now I'm inside this folder over here. Now let's try to compile the main.java file. I will say javac main.java. I will press enter and have a look. As you can see, the main.class file and the me.class file were generated. So what happened exactly? We wanted to compile main.java. And because we are using the me class inside the main class, the me class was also compiled, right? So now, as you know, the main method is inside the main class. So I'm going to execute main like this. Now, if I press enter, have a look. This is our output. Perfect. Now, let me delete these two classes, all right? And open CMD again. Look what I'm going to do. I will compile the me class. So Java C me.java. And as you can see, the me class was compiled. The main class was not compiled because we are not using the main class inside the me class. So Java only compiled the me.java. And now we can compile the main.java file like this. So Java C main.java. Now if we press enter, we can see that our main.class was created. And in this case, Java knows that the me.class was generated before. So it will not recompile me.java. So let's execute the program again, Java main, and we have the same result. Now what if we try to execute the me class? So Java me. What do you expect to see? I will press enter and have a look. The main method was not found in the class me. And this is true because we didn't create a main method in this class. Alright? So we have successfully created our program. And of course, doing it with IntelliJ is easier. So I will leave that for you to do. Great job for making it this far, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.